Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be sharing with you the sheet masks that I've used over the last couple months for June and July. Don't have a whole lot, not as much as I should have for someone that believes in masking. Just have gotten lazy about it, and I've got to get back on that game because I can sure tell with my skin the difference from not masking to as opposed to when I do mask on how my skin looks and feels and how my makeup goes on and everything. So without further ado, let's get started and let me show you what I've used and kind of what I think about them. The first thing I have here is from Bath and Body Works, and I did get this, not Bath and Body Works, darn it, I get those mixed up every single time. The Body Shop, and I did get this at Ulta. And it's the Himalayan Charcoal Purifying Glow Mask. And it was in this little pack right here. Let's see if I can get my camera to focus on that so you can kind of see. I don't know if you're going to be able to see with all the stuff on there. But this reminded me very strongly of the Glam Glow Purifying Mask, the original one that came out that has the little pieces in it, like seaweed or something like that. This definitely had some pieces in it. It worked the same. It was like a clay. It dried and it started pulling everything out of the pores. You could see it. And then when you went to rinse it, then those little particles that are in here helped to exfoliate the skin. So it was definitely a better and more cheaper option, I guess, to the Glam Glow, because Glam Glow is so expensive. The only thing about this though, that there was actually enough in this pack to use it twice, but it dried up too much for me to use again, so I kind of wasted some product in there. This was just a little trial pack, I guess, because it looks like it comes in a jar. So anyway, I got that at Ulta at the little impulse section at the checkouts. Yeah, got that there. I also did pick this up at Ulta. This is the Garnier Skin Active Moisture Balm Sheet Mask. It's supposed to be a super hydrating mask and glow boosting. And this is around like $4. I didn't care for this. I didn't feel like it was as moisturizing as what it claims to be. It was $4, and also I felt like as the essence started to dry down, it was felt very sticky and tacky, and I didn't care for that at all. So I won't purchase any more of those, and I'm glad I only got one of them. I have from Martini the Vitamin C Collagen Mask. I do like these masks. They are expensive, and they do have a lot of essence. They are designed to where you can use them a couple times if you want. A two-part mask, had lots of essence in it. As you see, it was very moisturizing, very cooling and calming, very good quality as far as the mask itself goes. Definitely do recommend those. They blah, 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 blah. They pop up on Holtlook quite often, so if you see those on Holtlook and you've been curious about the Martini mask, because even on Holtlook they're still expensive, they are a good mask. Here's another one for Martini. This is the Milk Collagen Mask. This one I don't recommend, and only for one reason, is that the product in here, the essence, it's a milky consistency. It looks like milk, but it's so drippy that it drips in my eyes and it just drips everywhere. I have to use this when I'm in the tub because it just gets everywhere. If it wasn't so drippy, maybe if it was just a little bit thicker and didn't run in the eyes, I would like it a whole lot better, because I do think milk products are very good for the skin. But I just don't recommend this one, just for the fact that it just ran and ran and was drippy. Another one for Martini, this is the Green Apple Collagen Mask. Another good one. Definitely smells like green apple. Now this one did tend to be a little bit sticky. So if you don't like anything that's sticky, you probably wouldn't like the green apple. But it was tolerable. I could deal with it. I didn't feel like I needed to go in and just completely rinse off my skin after using it. Here's another one of the martini milk ones. I had several of those. That was the last of my pile of those, and I had put off using them because I just didn't like them, but I'm getting through them. I think I'll have a couple more. Another martini one. This is the Lift Dermal Collagen Mask. I didn't care for this one at all. There was not enough essence in there. I felt like it was drying, and for what it was, I just didn't feel like it worked very good. So I would pass on that one. Another martini milk collagen mask. And let's see, I'm seeing if there's any more of the martini ones in here. There's not, though. That was all of the martini. I did use a eye mask. This is the Crystal Collagen Gold Powder Eye Mask. I'm not really for sure what brand this is from. This was sent to me. It was sent to me in a box of goodies from a subscriber. It just didn't have enough essence in it, so it wasn't really moisturizing under the skin. It was pretty cool looking because the little pads under there were gold, and so you had little gold eye patches on, but it just didn't do anything. And then I also have from Sephora some eye mask. Let's see, how many of these do I have in here? Let me get all these out. Okay, I have three of these. This is the Sephora Rose Eye Mask. I do like these, and I would definitely, when the sale comes up again in the fall, we'll probably purchase a good amount of these. I did like those. Very moisturizing. They stayed put underneath the eye. Very hydrating, and I felt like they worked really good. And let's see. I'm going to save those two for last. I have a couple that I'm going to save last. Oh, this is the 7 Days Mask for the Women. I ordered this off of the Peach and Lily website. This is really good. This is really good for exfoliation, definitely. It's for brightening with vitamins B3, and it smells wonderfully of lemon, and you really did feel like it was helping with exfoliating the skin and brightening, just like a vitamin C would do. So I did like that one quite a bit. And then I have, what brand is this? Oh, I don't know. It's oatmeal. JLC International Incorporation. It's this little oatmeal one. This was nice. It was very calming. I like to do something like this after I have used like a very strong chemical peel or a very strong scrub, just to help kind of calm the skin. So that really worked for that purpose. This is from Mizon. It's the Enjoy Vital Uptime Whitening Mask. Brighten your dull skin, containing white flower complex. I did enjoy that. I had ordered this when I ordered the rosehip oil spray that I like so much from this brand. So far this brand, this Mizon brand, I have been very, very impressed with. So did enjoy that. Also from Peach and Lily is the Dream Age Radiance Facial Mask. It's Rose by Dr. Dream. Of course, you know I'm going to like this because it is rose. I love anything to do with rose. I felt like this is a really good hydrating mask. It fit well. The sheet itself was good quality. No problems with this. It says functioning cosmetics for whitening and anti-wrinkle. So anyway, I do like that, and I would definitely think about ordering some more of those, but I have some more to use. Then I have the Vandu Beauty Friends. What is this called? Snake Venom. Oh, the Sinaki Essence Mask. Sinaki. Anyway, it's supposed to have snake venom in it. And I just really think that pretty much any sheet mask that you get from the Korean type brands are good. They know how to make good sheet masks, that is for sure. Then I have a Tony Moly I'm Real. This is a glass sheet for skin purifying. I don't know how to say that. Is that some kind of a milk? I don't know. I mean, that's what it looks like. It looks like a milk pitcher and everything, but I do like, I like the Tony Moly skin mask or sheet mask, and I've been seeing those at TJ Maxx here lately, so they're a little bit on the pricey side, but if you look at TJ Maxx, you might find some that are pretty good at a good price there, is what I'm trying to say. And then I have the Exuviance Performance Peel Pad, little duo. What you do is you do step one, which is the activator pad that has the glycolic in it, and you put it on your face with the little pad, let it set for a couple minutes, you're going to have some tingling, and then you have the neutralizer pad to put on top of it, which kind of helps settle down that tingling and helps the mask. Okay, now I want to talk about these next two masks. Wait, no I don't. I want to talk about this first. This was a little sample from Shiseido. This was a overnight mask, a sleeping mask, and it was very nice. I don't know if I would go and purchase it, but if I found this at TJ Maxx and it was at a good price, I would buy it then. And TJ Maxx has a lot of Shiseido products, so I'm going to keep my eye out for that. And it's the Ginza Tokyo Beauty Sleeping Mask. So that's what that is. Okay, now I was going to, and I probably still will feature these two in a favorites video, but this is the Too Cool for School Egg Cream Mask that I got at Sephora. Absolutely love this. Love the essence, the formulation, the sheet itself, the results that I get from it. It's a microfiber sheet, just like this whole egg cream. The egg cream aspect formulation of the mask. I also have a egg cream cleanser and egg cream moisturizer that I like from this brand, the Too Cool for School. It was in a kit that I bought. Anyway, so I was going to, you know, like highly recommend this, and they are pricey. I think one sheet is like $5 or something like that. So it is a pricey sheet mask, but I think it's worth it because it does work. And you're going to see results, especially if you use more than one and be consistent with it. So, but I have found a very, very good dupe for this at TJ Maxx and at Marshall's. I got this one at Marshall's, but I've got some at TJ Maxx. And it's by the Revive brand, and it's Extra Hydrating Mask Egg. It has egg, and it's coconut and egg extracts, and it looks like this. And these are $1.99. And I think that this was just as good as this one from the Too Cool for School, but at a fraction of the cost. Now, be careful though, because I've seen some of these at Marshall's. Some were marked $3.99 and some were marked $1.99. I don't know why. I don't know what. There was no difference. It was the same mask. I guess maybe they just got in different shipments and paid, the cost on them was different. But look for the ones that are marked $1.99. I got this one at Marshall's, but I also bought a handful of them at TJ Maxx. So I recommend this for, and they had different ones. That was the egg formulation, but it had different combinations with it. And this one's for hydrating. I think they had some for like oily skin and different things like that. So, but I'm more about hydration. And it's the coconut and egg extracts. So, yes. So, recommend that. I wish you could see that a little better. I'll try and have it linked in the description box. If there's not a link, at least I'll have the name of it written out for you so that you can at least do a visual of what, how the name's spelt and looks. So anyway, so that was it for my mask. Not a whole lot, really, for being for almost 2 months worth, but I'm going to get back on to the masking game and get my skin back in shape like it needs to be and go from there. So thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you have enjoyed, and I will talk to you later.